How do you recruit interviewees for your research project when you've got zero context and no idea where to start? One year into my PhD, I was about to embark on my fieldwork adventure in the film and TV industry. I quickly discovered that the film and TV industry is one of these closed spaces that can be really hard to navigate when you don't work in the industry yourself. I got lots of helpful advice from my supervisors, and I also closely read the methodology sections of studies that resembled mine. But still, you know, it's a bit of trial and error. You have to figure out what works in your specific context. So, here are six basic steps to follow when you're about to recruit interviewees, but don't really know where to start. Point number one, specify your target group. In my case, I focus on screenwriters, directors, and producers working in Europe. And these people had to tick a few boxes for them to be relevant for my study. I found that having some criteria, but then also fine-tuning the criteria along the way was really helpful. In terms of then finding the actual names of people, you'll have to embrace your inner secret agent or detective. First of all, I looked at press media releases from these big streaming services. I also looked at company websites and industry networks, relevant social media accounts all over the internet, it felt like, at least. When you've then found some names and you're thinking, might be worth reaching out to this person. Compile all of those names in a kind of database or a spreadsheet. It's a helpful way to track your progress along the way, and I open up my spreadsheet every single day and use it one way or another. Point number two, write an effective approach email. Now you might be thinking, I'm not ready to send an email, but I would recommend writing it anyways. It makes it crystal clear for you what you're actually looking for and what you hope to get out of the interview. Why are you contacting them? What's the kind of particular knowledge that only they have? You want to put yourself in the shoes of the person you're about to approach. What kinds of questions will they be wondering about? How much time will it take? What do they get out of it? And is it confidential? The goal is to convince people you're doing important research and that they'll add really valuable input to it by participating. And you basically want to communicate that it will be worth their while to commit the time and the energy to talk to you for, say, an hour or an hour and a half. Point number three, get the word out. Maybe you've got their contact details. If so, go ahead, just contact them. Oftentimes in these closed industries, it's not that simple. And you might have to find other ways of getting a hold of these email addresses. For film and TV people, it's actually really helpful to look at professional databases. You may only find the contact information of this particular person's agent, but that's not bad either, because agents, it turns out, are friendly, helpful people. A lot of the agents that I contacted forwarded my request to the person I was looking to contact. That leads me to my next point, gatekeepers and networks. What are the kinds of organizations and institutions that they would find trustworthy? Getting gatekeepers to post on their social media channels is a lot better in my experience. Point number four, follow up. since your interview is something they don't really have to do, it's easy to put it at the very bottom of their to-do list. So following up is absolutely necessary. A lot of people also won't reply, but you know, when you contact enough people, you contact more than you actually need. I found that you do get the interviews you need in the end. And that feeling when you then get a positive reply, the interview is in the diary, it's going to happen. Point number five, snowball. I always end my interviews with asking if the person I'm talking to can recommend anybody else. I have to admit that some of my best and most informative interviews have come from those recommendations. The very last point is to keep a methodology diary, preferably in a delightful color. Use this diary to record your thoughts, experiences, and also just general reflections on the recruitment process. What are the barriers that you encountered? If you have any tips or ideas for recruiting interviewees in your specific field, write them in the comments. Let's get the discussion going and help each other. So, all there's left to say is, let's get to work.